Good morning. Jesus is Lord. Thank God. The word works. James chapter 3. Such a powerful truth. Verse 3. Behold, we put bits in the horses' mouths, that they may obey us, and we turn about their whole body. Behold also the ships, which though they be so great and are driven of fierce winds, yet are they turned about with a very small helm, whithersoever the governor listeth. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasteth great things. So he's saying that the tongue is the thing, is like the rudder. The tongue is like the bit in the horse's mouth. But you know, before the tongue, the rudder can do anything, or the bit can do anything, the person that's riding the horse or the captain of the ship has to decide which way that ship is going, which way that horse is going. And this is the emphasis that is so important for you, because religion has so messed up the way a believer should be living their life. God has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness, but it's up to each one of us to possess our land. It's up to each one of us to inherit the promises that have been given to us. In Romans, he says, we don't have to go get Jesus to come down again or be raised up again. He said, but what saith it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. So the will of God is in the word of God. The word of God is the will of God. And Jesus said, I came that you might have life. And that's life, the life of God, life on the level, life in every area. Because we were born into death in every area. But when we were born again, and if you're not, just ask Jesus to come in and to be your Lord. That's all you have to do, is confess Jesus as Lord. You don't even have to confess your sins. Who can confess all their sins, right? You just confess Jesus as Lord. And then you are translated at that moment out of the power of darkness, out of death, into life, into light, into the kingdom of God, where Jesus is Lord, and you have an inheritance, but you have to receive that inheritance. And that inheritance is far greater than any one of us can imagine. Do you remember, or maybe you didn't know this, but when God spoke to Abram and he told him, he said, look now from where you are, to the north, the south, the east, and the west. And he said, as far as you can see, that I have given to you. So don't look at where you are right now. You look, you know, the captain of the ship has in mind a destination. Say, if the ship is going to England from the United States, it has a course. It has a destination in mind. That ship's not out there just doing its own thing. It's not left to the mercy of the winds and the waves. Well, neither is your life left to the mercy of the winds and the waves. Your life is controlled by your tongue. Let me share with you a couple of examples that as we were learning this, then what would come into our mind when we would hear of a tragedy, we would say, what was said? Well, when we were young ministers, oh my, years and years ago, and Frank would meet with three or four other ministers, and they would pray on Saturday night. And this one particular minister, and where they would pray, there was a railroad track that was running close to that church. And this one minister said, and just laughed about it, and said, someday that train's going to run over me. Well, you know what? That train ran over him. Why? Because his tongue set on fire the course of nature. And so the angels couldn't protect him because he said with his mouth. Now listen, God says what he desires, And so the angels think that what you say is what you desire. Jesus said to us, what things, Mark 11:24, what things soever you desire. So start there. Start thinking, do I desire to be run over by a train? No, then don't say it. Do I desire for my children to fall out of a tree and break a limb? Again, when we were first learning this, and we had a neighbor down the street that his son climbed up in a tree, and he said, hey, come down or you're going to fall and break your arm. You know what? The boy fell and broke his arm. Well, I remember when a few years later, when our boys were in the top of a tree and the limb was just swinging, and Frank and I looked at each other and we said, the angels bear them up, no evil shall befall them, they will not fall. You know what? They didn't. We didn't even tell them to come out of the tree. So your words affect you, they affect your spouse, they affect your children, they affect everything around you. You are the one that is, you are framing your world. In Hebrews, it says that through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God. You frame your world from this moment on by the word of God. I'll share a couple more examples with you tomorrow. But for today, remember, guard your mouth. David said this, set a watch, set a guard on my mouth, O Lord. Keep watch at the door of my lips. You wonder what door you open? Keep watch at the door of my lips. Have a blessed day. Remember, Jesus is Lord. Thank God the word works.